it's my incredible honor to introduce our guest artist for this evening, Necati Çelik, one of the most renowned Turkish musicians, players of the oud, the instrument that you'll become acquainted with here if you don't already know it. Necati is currently the Roberta Bauman Denning Visiting Artist in Residency at the Abbasi Program in Islamic Studies at Stanford University. And it's with the generous help of a few sponsors that we've been able to steal him away for a few days from Stanford. So I'd like to thank the School of Music, Dance, and Theater and the Malikian Center for Russian, Eurasian, and East European Studies for supporting tonight's concert. A little bit more about Mr. Çelik, our guest. He was born in 1955 in Konya, a city in central Turkey. And he began playing Turkish folk music. Konya is known for a particular sound of Turkish folk music that includes the long neck lute balama, which was Necati Hoca's first instrument. I call him Hoca, which means teacher. But it also combines balama with oud, the instrument we'll hear tonight, and kanun, a zither, kind of zither. And so he grew up in that tradition. His first teacher was Haki Zambak, a very good oud player from Konya. And later he studied with Kadri Şençalar, and then finally Cinu Çentanrıkurur, one of the best known oud players from a generation prior to Necati Hoca. And he also studied with Necdet Yaşar, a very prominent tambur player. And he's played for many years with Turkey's best known musicians. He's performed in a number of countries around the world, Malaysia, Jordan, Dubai, Qatar, Tunisia, Morocco, Algeria, Germany, Belgium, Greece. It goes on and on. And he's actually been to the US and Canada a number of times and performed. He's toured solo, he's toured with Necdet Yaşar's ensemble. But we're very fortunate because it's been about, we think, 10 years since he was here in the US last. And this is going to be his first performance, his first concert while in the country. So we're very fortunate. And I got to know Necati Hoca at his studio in Istanbul. He has an office where he'll just kind of hang out every afternoon, and anybody's free to come in. And there's a sort of informal setting. In Turkish, it's known as sohbet, a kind of like slightly formalized kind of conversation around tea and coffee drinking and various subjects discussing culture. And then as you're sitting there, he might say, okay, my student, you know, let's see what you've been working on, pull out your oud, play for him, and then he'll show you some things, give you some pointers, and give you some instructions for the next time you come. And also while you're there, these incredible people come through the door, musicians from all over the world, the best musicians in Turkey come through the door. I've met people from all kinds of countries, from Syria, from parts of Europe, all over the place. And so it's just a kind of wonderful environment, just to give you a sense of some of his working environment. He's also a member of a state Turkish music ensemble, which I'll just say something about the tradition in which he performs, which is perhaps best known as classical Turkish music, we could call it that, although it's a tradition that really emerged from within the Ottoman Empire among diverse communities of people. In diverse contexts, from the Ottoman Palace, which was a great patron of music historically, to Sufi lodges. The Mevlevi Sufi order was very well known for producing musicians in this tradition. And then other social contexts. And all of this was sort of recontextualized in the 20th century with the founding of the modern Republic of Turkey, which shut down many of the old institutions that supported the forms of music that we now know as classical Turkish music. And new institutions of patronage took their place. So the state ensemble in which Necati Hoca performs is one example of this. But there's also radio ensembles, conservatories, different contexts like that. Now, the music is structured, one of the key organizing principles is the idea of makam, which is a kind of melodic modal system. So we can think of, in Western music, kind of roughly, we have major and minor as different kind of sonorities or tonalities. And in this musical tradition, there are hundreds of different kind of sonorities, let's say, like that, that involve scales, a particular scale, but also kind of instructions for moving through that scale, right? And so, anyway, there ends up being hundreds of different ways to create these different modes that have different flavors to them. So tonight we'll hear, Necati Hoca is going to announce from the stage what he'll play, and he doesn't have a set list planned. He's just going to play what comes to him in the moment. So he'll let us know, he'll probably tell us the makam, and then the name of the work. Often it will be just the name of a kind of form, in a traditional form. He'll, if we're lucky, we'll also perhaps hear him perform one of his original compositions, and he might also sing a song. So the performance should be a little more than an hour, with no intermission, just so you know. So anyway, it's my incredible honor to welcome Necati Çelik. I hope you all enjoy the performance. Please give a huge round of applause.
I'm very excited, I'm very happy, very proud is improvisation. Then I played Uşak Semai. Now I want to play from my master, Cunurcan Tanrı Korur, in Hüseyini Makam. Also, it is Semai. Thank you. Okay. always out of tune.
Thank you.
Tamburi Cemil Bey. Maybe some of you heard it. Tamburi Cemil Bey, very important musician for Turkish music. So I want to play his Ferah Feza Taksim Semai. Of course.